Now let's import a forest picture in the project. So click on File, Open. And open the forest image. Then just move it to your current project with the process as was shown before. Again, we can see the picture is too big, so let's resize it. Again, click on the layer where you have the forest. First, let's zoom out a little bit. Then click on Edit and Free Transform and scale down the image. At the end, click OK. And I would like quickly to uncheck the snapping to guides. Let's first rename the layer. So let's type in just forest. And move the layer behind the house. Now let's make the forest layer black and white. To achieve that, select the forest layer, click on Image, Adjustments, Black and White. Click on OK at the end. Now select the house layer and make it also black and white. So click on Image, Adjustments, Black and White. When you're pleased with the effect, click on OK. Now select the house layer again, and with the eraser, let's delete the part of this layer. So select the size of the eraser and let's move the hardness to 0% and click once, hold shift and click again and repeat the process. Now let's readjust the house layer, so click on selection tool and move it. Then move the forest, click on forest layer and move the forest. Let's make the forest a little bit bigger, so choose the free transform tool and scale up the forest. Then just choose the forest layer and again with the eraser delete a little bit of the forest layer. So again, select house layer and delete a little bit of the house image. When you finish with that, let's add the lights into the window. So just zoom in a little bit, then create a new layer and name it Window Lights. And simply choose the rectangle marquee tool and make a selection. Then when you make first selection, hold down the shift key and make another selection. Repeat the process. Hold down the shift key and make another selection. When you finish with adding selections, just click on layer and choose yellow color. And click on the paint bucket tool and simply click in the selection. Then let's deselect the selection. So select, deselect. And now simply lower down the opacity. And click on the layer styles icon and add inner glow. So increase the size. And this is pretty much all. Just click on OK. And let's zoom out a little bit. And you can see the effect looks great, but let's just delete a little bit of the yellow color. So just choose again Eraser, choose the size, and let's set the hardness to 0. Let's see how this looks. So zoom out. It looks good. Now let's create the reflection on the floor. So create a new layer, name it Reflection on the Floor. Now just simply take rectangle tool over here, choose the color, and simply draw selection. Before you start with drawing, choose this option over here. After you draw a selection, choose Free Transform tool. And here choose Perspective. Move these points to the top part of the shape. Now you can scale from that point. So this is pretty much all right. Now just confirm that changes with Enter key and lower the opacity. Take the brush and change the color to black. Before we can do the changes to this type of the layer, we have to rasterize this layer. So you can simply click on it with right mouse button and click Rasterize layer, and simply add a layer mask, click on this icon, and then select the black color and choose the brush. And now simply delete a little bit of the reflection. This works because I selected the mask from this layer, and when you have mask selected, you can choose the black color to delete the stuff from that layer, or the white color to bring back some of the stuff. Or let's bring a little bit of this shadow back. To bring a little bit of shadow back, just click on, select the white color and click on the mask and just paint with brush. Let's select the brush again and increase the hardness and click once. Change the color first to black, click once and hold shift. Change the color again. Okay, this looks good. So let's continue with the next thing. Before we proceed, let's add the layer styles to reflection on the floor. So select it first and click layer styles icon and click on inner glow. Now just play a little bit with the settings. And then select the outer glow. And increase it a little bit. Lower the opacity. And click on OK. Let's add outer glow to the window light too. So select the window lights and choose outer glow. increase it a little bit. Let's decrease the opacity for a little bit. Click OK. Now let's move the forest and the house a little bit down. So just select the first, hold down the shift, click on forest, and then just the selection tool move the image a little bit down. Now click on the last layer and choose a text tool, and let's create a text for our DVD cover. First, I will just copy the text. I prepared something, so the title for my imaginary movie is A Thrilling House. So again, click on text, click inside of it, and paste the text. Let's select this and increase the size of it. Let's change the color to red. And then click on this option and let's adjust a little bit the text. Let's zoom in a little bit. We should add a stroke around this text. So just select the layer with the text and click on layer styles icon. Then just click on stroke and create a stroke. Let's first decrease the stroke. So just double click on the effect here and click on stroke and decrease the size of the stroke for a little bit. Then just click on OK and let's rasterize the layer. Click on it with right mouse button and rasterize type. Now choose the layer where you have the text, then go to Edit and Free Transform and choose Perspective. And let's scale it a little bit, not too much. Then click just to check. Let's warp it for a little bit. And then just click on check. Now let's add another text. So I will just add at the bottom a quote. So first let's copy the quote. And let's choose a text tool, click once in it, and paste the text. Select the text, Control and A is the shortcut, then choose the text color. Decrease the size of the text. Let's zoom in a little bit. Double click on the thumbnail of the text to adjust it. Select the text again, click on this icon and adjust it. And just click on the check. and lower the space between the text. And click on check. Let's zoom in a little bit. Move the text to the center. Now let's import another image to our project. Move it in our project. And let's quickly with eraser remove the unnecessary parts. I would like to have just the eye of this animal. So let's begin. Choose the eraser. Choose the size of it. Make hardness to 0 and begin. Now just increase the eraser, move the hardness to the end and erase the unnecessary things. Now click on Alt and move the eye to the right. And you have made the copy of the eye. Now just rename these two layers. Select the layer of this eye, go to Edit, Transform, flip horizontally. Now let's grab both eyes. So select both layers with Shift key and go to Edit, Free Transform and scale the eyes for a little bit. And then just click on the check. Now let's decrease the opacity to 80%. Let's rearrange a little bit these items on the screen. So I would like to delete the forest image for a few pixels. So select the forest image. Use the eraser. And you're done. Now move the eyes a little bit down. And this is all for the front side of the DVD cover.